morning. This is KNDO TV operating on Channel 23 located in Yakima, Washington, serving Central Washington, including the Kittitas and Yakima Valleys. Our effective radiated peak power is 500,000 watts visually and 62,000 watts orally by the authority of the Federal Communication Commission in Washington, D.C. KNDO is owned and operated by the Columbia Empire Broadcasting Corporation with studios located at 1608 South 24th Avenue in Yakima, Washington, and a transmitter atop a Tandem Ridge. Have a good day. We'll be right back.
In Yakima, Kelly Shinoda, KNDO News 23.
Parking restrictions here along Yakima Avenue have helped.
Reporting in Yakima, I'm Stephanie Fisher for KNDO News 23.
At the Yakima County Courthouse, Dave Cochran, KNDO News 23.
We're live at the Sundome.
Good evening. Thanks for joining me. I'm Shelley Swanky.
I like it when employers ask, what kind of workers do you have at People for People? I laugh and say, workers, just like me. I'm a career development counselor at People for People, and 6 years ago, I started at the agency as a job training participant. As you can see by a wall of success, People for People has many stories just like mine. Thank you. So when employers ask, where can I find a great employee? I tell them, call People for People. A professional like myself will help you find a skilled or non-skilled worker just right for your business. Call now. You could end up with someone just like me.
Sally Jesse Raphael, weekdays at 10.
The Ag Department looks at overhauling the crop insurance program. More and more farmers are farming out some of their work. And foresters are targeting Mexico for lumber sales.
AgDay, brought to you by American Cyanamid. We'll give you the resources to succeed even when the ground rules change. And by the Federal Crop Insurance Corporation, providing risk management for the 90s.
Good morning and welcome to AgDay. I'm Al Pell. The 1995 Farm Bill may include free crop insurance for farmers. That's if the plan makes it through Congress. Currently, less than 40% of eligible farmland is covered by the federal crop insurance program. One reason is that when there's a disaster, Congress approves emergency disaster aid. Thus, even farmers without insurance get something. Providing free insurance would actually cost less than $1.5 billion now spent every year on crop losses. But the dollars spent to aid farmers would have to be figured into the federal budget. Right now, disaster payments don't count as part of the budget because they can't be predicted. That's why some members of Congress are expected to fight the change. Bad weather is the reason cotton yields are lower than normal in Louisiana. But as reporter John Brooks explains, growers are reporting increases in lint to the acre.
Louisiana cotton producers produced cotton on some 875,000 acres this past growing season, which resulted in a little more than 1.1 million bales. But lint per acre averaged only 606 pounds, about 100 pounds below the most recent five-year average. So what happened this year?
Weather conditions, excessive rainfall at times, and an extensive drought, particularly in late July and August, had a lot to do with it.
Birch also says higher than average temperatures in July and August and insect pests accounted for the reduction too. In spite of the off year, Birch says over the last 20 years, average lint per acre in Louisiana cotton fields improved.
There's a steady increase in yields from in 73 through 77. I think we had an average of about 500 pounds of lint to the acre. You get on up to the most recent period of time, the five-year average was something like 725 or 730 pounds of lint to the acre.
There are many reasons for the increases, better equipment, better pest controls, managing for early harvest, but one factor seems to be most significant.
I think one of the primary ones in Louisiana is that we're doing a lot more irrigating now than we did in 15 or 20 years ago. And of course, supplying water when it's needed through the summer can have a dramatic effect on the yield of a crop of cotton.
From the LSU Agricultural Center, this is John Brooks reporting for Ag Day.
The problem of black root rot in cotton is spreading through Texas. Formerly, it was only seen in California and along the Texas-New Mexico border. Black root rot attacks the seedling root system, stunting the growth of the cotton. Growers have two methods of fighting it. One, replanting the affected fields, or two, applying a seed treatment such as Baytan 30 prior to planting. Ag Secretary Mike Espy says he's already trimming millions of dollars in the Ag Department's budget, and the costs are coming before the massive reorganization of the USDA, designed to save $1.3 billion between now and 1998. Espy says in 1993, he saved $146 million by trimming a staff at the Ag Department. Now Nancy David is here with a look at today's weather.
The big winter storm that dumped several inches of snow in the Northeast, it will be a mere memory today as it continues to work its way up into the Canadian Maritimes. Good news for the skiers, though. Lots of snow up there.
Yeah, exactly.
But a cold Canadian high-pressure system for the Northern Plains and a much-needed quiet weather day for the Four Corners. As far as high temperatures today, 10 to 20 below zero for North Dakota, Minnesota, and Wisconsin. And lows overnight, they should bottom out minus 20 to minus 30 in some locations. Could even bottom out at minus 40, 40 degrees below zero. And coming up in weather, we're going to take a look at some winter tips on how to stay warm.
So we can say a severe cold forecast coming up.
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks, Nancy.
So say it.
Grain prices taking a big tumble. Let's take a look at the prices in the bottom line.